My name is Kelly Nissen. I'm a graduate student in Christine Guthrie's lab at University of California, San Francisco. And our lab is interested in pre-mRNA splicing in yeast. What's really interesting about RNA splicing in our cells is that it's important for production of everything in the cell. So there are estimates that 10 to 15% of all heritable diseases are errors in this process. So from cancer to developmental disorders, it's a very fundamental process to all of life. So I spend a lot of my day at my lab bench. I do a lot of molecular techniques, so I'm growing yeast, breaking them open and taking out their DNA or their RNA. Experiments might take me the majority of the day. And I also spend some time on my computer analyzing the data. So I run a women's group here on campus called Women in Life Sciences, and we're interested in fostering mentorship, networking, and just support for women here on campus. I mean, I guess part of my entry into science is to combine my interest in travel with my professional life. I'm drawn to this idea of discovery, that I'm coming in every day to learn something new that no one else knows before, and that it might have a direct impact on our community, whether it's through human health or technology. I want to contribute to our society, and I want to be the first to know how the genome is working. I think I'm just really interested in that. I've always been interested in science. As a little girl, I wanted to be a chemical engineer, which sounds kind of, I guess, lofty for a child, but my mom sold pharmaceuticals, and so I wanted to be the scientist that made them to help people. In high school, I was really interested in chemistry, but I had this really great biology professor who kind of opened me up to this whole new world of what happens inside of our bodies. I had no idea that you can turn parts of your genome on and off, and that genes can jump around the genome. They can cut themselves out of the fabric of our DNA and move to other places. And this idea that inside your cell and inside the nucleus where all the DNA is, there's its own little ecosystem really fascinated me. And so that led me to pursue biology in college. Neither of my parents come from a science background, but work in sort of, pharmaceuticals or technology. So I'm the first person in my family to go to graduate school. I feel like going to graduate school is a good decision if you're thinking about science because it lends itself to many careers. I don't have to just go and be a bench scientist for the rest of my life. I can contribute to the community in other ways, through policy or funding and foundations, advocacy, education. I don't feel limited to just being sort of the stereotypical bench scientist, and that I can have a positive role in my community both through my bench work and through other opportunities. Science is fulfilling because I get to wake up every day and do something that I love, that it's both work and play for me. I get to be creative and think of new experiments and learn something that nobody else knows. If I were to give advice to someone who's interested in biomedical research, I would encourage them to get their feet wet, to email somebody and ask, "Can I help out?" I think it's really important to get experience in the lab and see if it's what you like. And if it's not, that's totally fine too. But for me, it hooked me in, and I'm really glad that I decided to volunteer my time as an undergraduate, and I'm looking forward to my career as a scientist. Thank you.